Multilingual Neural Machine Translation Service, developed by Google to translate text, documents, and website from one language to another. Yes, people, I am talking about Google Translate, and this is a brief beginner's guide for using it. Welcome to Tutorials Point, and before starting, you can subscribe to our channel for more videos and updates. So, let's get started. The very initial part of learning to use Google Translate is having it, and for this, go to an App Store or Play Store. Just like me, and tap on the search for apps and games option on the top. Insert here Google Translate. Search for this particular app. Now tap on install on the top right corner and wait for it to get it installed and download it. After you have downloaded and installed it completely, tap on this open option on the bottom right. Tap on done to operate the translate offline option. You can operate it just now. Alright, just after installing it, make sure to get logged in with one of your Google account. Tap on the three straight parallel lines in the top left corner. You can see that I am logged in with one of my Google account. Tap on it. You can choose any of the email address or the Google account itself to get logged in. I have chosen my own. You can also do the same. Now I'm onto my home page, and today I'll explain about each and every icons present on the screen. Starting with the two language chosen for translating, just below Google Translate, you can see English and Spanish. That means I am trying to translate English text to Spanish. And with the feature allowed by the app itself, it can be changed as well. For that, tap on the language part. If you want to change English, tap on English, and you'll get all of the languages option. And you can choose your option accordingly. And for Spanish, you can tap on Spanish and choose the other language that you want to change it to. But if you want to interchange it and translate your Spanish text to English, you can tap on this interchange arrow section on just between the two of the languages. And you can see that the language had just been interchanged from Spanish to English. All right. Now, below it, the important part, how to use the text translation feature. For using the text translation feature, just below you can see two of the icon next to this. Tap to translate. Tap to enter text on the right corner. You can see two of the icon. That is a mic icon and a pen icon. Tap on this pen icon. You can see that you can enter text and that will be translated to Spanish. You have two of the option. The first one is the keyboard option and the second one is of a handwriting option. To enable it, tap on this pencil icon on the right corner. You'll get two of the option, keyboard and handwriting. To enable writing through keyboard, you can tap on keyboard and the keyboard will arise here. I'm going to write one of the texts that will be translated to Spanish. Just look at it. I have just kept one of the particular texts that I want to translate from English to Spanish, and you can see just below there is a proper translation. If you want to see it in a full screen, you can tap on this rightward directed arrow just on the right of this Spanish translation. And yes, this is the particular translation. If you want to hear it, tap on this mic icon just in front of Spanish.
Hermoso de tu parte tener la espalda de tu pareja.
How beautiful of you to have your partner's back.
So this is it. This is how you use the tap to translate with a keyboard feature. Going back, now tap on this pencil icon once again, and I'll show you how to use the handwriting feature. For that, you need to tap on this pencil icon once again on the right corner. You will get handwriting. Below you tap on handwriting. Here, just below, you can write here anything that you want to translate. I am going to write something randomly. For that, you need to just slide your fingers around and it will just appear and disappear. You can randomly write it and stop it, and they'll realize that you have just completed your sentence. So you can see that I can write off my own and they're going to translate it properly. So this is it. This is a proper translation from English to Spanish. And to watch it in a full screen, you can again tap on this rightward directed arrow below and tap on this mic.
¿Cómo estuvo su día?
So this is a proper translation by using the text translation. This is how you do it. After this text translation below, you can see three of the icon. That is camera, conversation, and transcribe. These are really important one for the Google Translate app itself. If you want to click the picture and enable photos option for that, you can use a camera one. Tap on this camera and you can see that there is a new camera translation. You'll get three of the facility. That is automatic language detection, better translation quality, and even more languages are supported. So if you want to continue Anyway, tap on this continue option on the bottom right, and you need to allow Translate to take pictures and record video. So below it, you can see three of the facility for it. That is instant, scan, and import. I'll show you how these three works. The first one, instant one. For this, you need to aim at a text. So I'm going to keep one of the sample bottle and I'm going to aim at a text. Before it, you can see that it's Head and Soldier Shampoo. This is the proper translation from English to Spanish, Head and Soldier. So if you want to see it properly, you can pause translation below, tap on pause translation. You can see this is the particular translation by using the instant feature. If you want to continue translation and then focus on next text, you can tap on continue translation below and then aim at other translation or the text just like this. Tap on pause translation to see it properly. So this is it. This is how you use the instant feature on camera. The next one is a scan on the bottom center. Tap on it. For this, you need to scan at the particular text that you want to translate. I'm going to click the picture properly. And now you can see that on the top, you can use a finger to highlight the text after taking the proper picture. Either you can select all by tapping on select all on the bottom, you can see. If you want to just translate the proper text, you can tap on particular text and make it highlighted by sliding it just like this. I'm going to choose Head and Soldier. And when I'm done, I'm going to tap on this right redirected arrow for this proper translation. So this is it. This is how you use the camera's feature, that is the scan one. So I have just told you about instant and scan. The final one is of the import on the bottom right. Tap on import. For this, you need to allow Translate to access photos, media, and files from your device. Tap on allow. Now you can take any of the picture from the gallery that you want to translate. I'm going to take one of the gallery picture that I want to translate. This is the proper translation form which you can do of the text present on the picture from your gallery. For this, I'm going to use my finger again to highlight text. So I'm going to use this form quotation, and then when it's done, tap on this right redirected arrow below this translation. So this is it.
La felicidad no es algo que esperar, sino lo que creas.
Happiness is not a thing to wait for, but what you create.
So this is it. This is how you use the camera feature. I have just told you about every feature that's present on camera. And the flash one, obviously. You can use it at the darkness and use it for the lighting feature by enabling this flashlight on the top right corner. You can just use it. Alright, I'm going to aim at text just like this. So this is it. After this camera feature comes the conversation feature. Just in the bottom center, you can see next to camera, tap on conversation. For this, you need to allow Translate to record audio. So you can see there are two of the language and three of the option, that is English, Auto, and Hindi. If I'm going to speak any of the text in English, they are going to represent in the form of conversation and translate it to Hindi or any of the other language that I'll choose on the right side or even on the left side. For this, we need to tap on this mic icon below the particular language and speak for it. And the auto one represents both of the language that we have chosen. We can prefer to speak in English or Hindi, and they will just translate it into the next language. So I'll just show you the demo. I'm going to speak something in English and they'll just translate it into Hindi. For that, tap on this mic icon below English on the bottom left. Something about this girl is so beautiful. So yes, it has been successfully translated. Now we can speak something in Hindi and they are going to translate it into English again. For that, tap on this mic icon below Hindi.
मुझे लगता है कि मैं आपको जानती हूँ.
I think I know you.
So this is it. You can just have a proper conversation by tapping on the mic icon and then speak on the particular language and they are going to translate it into the opposite one. I am going to tap on this mic icon below auto and speak in any of the language and they are going to detect it easily.
How have you been these days? I thought you were lost.
आप कैसे हो सकते हैं? इन दिनों आप खो गए हैं?
आपको पता है मैं आपके बारे में बहुत ज्यादा चिंतित थी.
You know I was so worried about you.
So this is it. This is how you use the conversation feature on the Google Translate. Wasn't it fun? It was, right? So if you want to save it, you can tap on this rightward directed arrow on the top right corner next to translation and get back again. Next to conversation is a transcribe feature. Tap on this transcribe feature. But before that, I would love to tell you that transcribe is a feature on Google Translate where you can put your thoughts, speech, or data in a return form. They are going to translate completely the whole pattern into one another language. So it's going to be a whole text. It's a proper speech and the proper data. So I'm going to tap on transcribe next to conversation on the right corner. Tap on got it. I'm going to speak something in English and they're going to translate it to Hindi. I never thought that we are meeting like this because I have always seen your parents when I was a child. And as an adult, this is a different experience. I wish I could tell them that I already knew them. So you can see that this is not just a small word, but it's a complete sentence. And yes, there's all of the sentence that has been converted from one language to another. And if you want to save it, you can tap on the star icon on the top right corner. Save, keep a name for it. I'm going to keep one of the name. You can also do the same. And then tap on save option on the right corner. Proper transcribe will be saved easily. So I am going to speak in another language once again. I want to speak in Hindi and then I want it to be translated to English. For that, we need to tap on this English on the top and choose your Hindi instead. They are going to interchange the particular language. I'm going to speak by tapping on this mic icon on the bottom center. Something in Hindi, they're going to translate into English.
मुझे लगता है कि मैं आपको जानती हूँ. हम बचपन से साथ हैं, लेकिन कभी हमने बात नहीं की. मैं चाहती हूँ कि मैं आपके परिवार से मिलूँ, उनको जानूँ और आपके बारे में भी बहुत ज्यादा सुना है. क्या मैं आपके साथ आपके घर चल सकती हूँ?
So when you've done it, you can see that this is the proper transcribe and translation from Hindi to English. You have a gear icon on the bottom left. Tap on it. You can increase or decrease the text size here, choose a theme and show the original text and even send the feedback. I have just shown you that all of the feature, how to use the camera, conversation and the transcribe. The next one is obviously of how to use the offline translation and how to use the tap to translate feature and how to even clear the history. For that, you need to tap on the three straight parallel lines on the top left corner. You can see that here is an offline translation feature. Above that is a save transcribe. Tap on save transcribe. You just remember, right? We have saved two of the transcribe. That was Billy's Day and Dolphin's Dilemma. You can tap on three straight dotted lines on the right corner and then rename it or delete it. Towards the save transcribe was there. Below it is an offline translation feature. Tap on offline translation feature. Offline translation feature allows you to translate, use the Google Translate app even without any Wi-Fi or internet connection. So I'll show you how to do it. You can see there are two of the downloaded language. The first one is English and the second one is Spanish. English is automatically the download language and I had just downloaded the Spanish one. So I'm going to download one of the language. Let me download Italian. For this, you need to get to that particular language and then tap on this downward directed arrow on the right corner and then tap on download next to cancel and wait for it to get it downloaded. On the top, you can see that it is being starting to download and it will be downloaded soon. After downloading and installing the particular required language for an offline translation, you can use it now and I'll show you how to do it. You can turn off the Wi-Fi just like this. Make sure to make it offline. And yes, going back, you can see that you're offline here. I'm going to keep it to Spanish. And for both of the languages, that is English and Spanish, which is available offline, now I can use it. We have two of the feature available offline. Conversation and transcribe is not available offline, but the camera feature and the tap to enter text is available offline. So for that, I've already told you how to use it. You can just use the handwriting or the keyboard option by tapping on this keyboard on the bottom right and choose any of them and get started all over again. And even for the camera one, you can tap on this camera. You can see all of the feature available, that is instant scan and import, and even the flash one. So this is it. This is how you use an offline translation easily. Now, after offline translation, make sure to get into your Wi-Fi once again. Now, I'll tell you how to clear the history. You need to tap on the three straight parallel lines on the top left corner. Tap on settings below offline translation. Tap on clear history on the bottom. Tap on yes. So just by doing it, you can go back and see that all of your history has been deleted. Now, the most important part, tap to translate feature. For that, you need to tap on the three straight parallel lines on the top left corner once again. Tap on settings below offline translation. You can see on the top, there's an option
option of tap to translate. Tap on it. This is disabled right now. If you want to enable it, you need to tap on the sliding icon next to enable and make it enable just like this. So tap to translate feature allows you to use Google Translate in any of the other apps. I'll show you in one of the app by using it. Let us go to YouTube. Tap on this magnifying glass on the top and use any of the language. For that, you need to just slide it, bring the screen down, and then tap on this tap to translate is on option. I'm going to translate it into Spanish, writing here, just like this. Now tap and copy on the bottom right. You can see that you have copied one of the particular text from English to Spanish. Now you can search for it. And yes, these are the particular search related to this translation. So this is how you use tap to translate feature in any of the other app. So this helps you to allow to not just use it for Google, but for any other apps as well. So this is it. This is how you use it. And for the phrase book or even the saved one that I have saved before, or the something that you have just started before, you can watch it on the phrase book. For that, tap on the three straight parallel lines at the top left corner. Tap on phrase book below home. You can see these are all the starred translation. You can come and watch here. This is it. This is how you use all of the feature related to it. I'm already on the home screen once again, and I've already explained you about each and every icon present on the screen. I hope this video was really helpful for you and I was able to help you. I am going to see you on the next video. For more videos related to Google Translate, go and visit our channel, and for more help related to web and tech also, you can go and visit there. I'll see you in the next video. Till then, keep calm, stay safe, and goodbye.